Hey guys, Coastal Backwoods here. This is a video response for the Three River Tell Us Your Knife story. Don't have a very, very long one, but we'll start. This is the first knife that I got from my grandfather up in upstate New York, up in the Berkshire Mountain area. This isn't the exact one, but it's pretty daggone close. Like a generic little Swiss Army knife. This one actually still has the tweezers and the never before used toothpick in it. Still, I think everybody at some point has had one of these. Just a little blade on this guy, just a little simple utility piece. The first set I had, I think I wore those scissors out, cutting everything that I could possibly cut and probably things I shouldn't have. I think that's how I broke it actually. And just the normal little nail file, clean your toe jam out kind of stuff right here, and then just a little simple sharp blade. That's the first thing they trusted me with, was this little guy right here. I carried one of those for quite a while growing up, and then the next one that I got was given to me by my grandfather shortly after he passed away. This again isn't the same one I beat the crap out of and subsequently lost, and well, you know how that is. Just a Swiss Army knife, a little bit longer, a little bit bigger, stainless blade, just your average run-of-the-mill thing here. I remember growing up, I think I was about 10, I took this corkscrew, well, not this specific one, but the one that I had, and I just, for some reason, felt the need to drill, and I remember breaking this thing off because I would just push as hard as I possibly could into a piece of wood until the thing just snapped off at every heat and popped out. So this thing's got a bunch of gunk in it, but growing up a little bit more. Then eventually, I think this one was given to me by my father. It's just a Schrade Uncle Henry, I believe. Yeah, Uncle Henry, right up here. Now this thing probably has seen the most use. I abused this thing growing up through my teenage years, and I don't know if you can see the horrible sharpening jobs on this guy, but this guy has had the crap beat out of it. This blade right here broke off. You can see the hook in there where we've just kind of drilled away at it and just ruined this thing. And I think it was a sheep's foot. Snapped off a couple places right there. I see it pretty good there. And again, horrible sharpening job. But, this thing spent a lot of time in my pocket. A lot of time. And now it just kind of sits in a drawer. It's one of those things I'm never going to get rid of, Now, these two kind of came along about the same time. I think when these things came out, I think everybody kind of jumped on the bandwagon. And you know what? It's still freaking useful. This is the first one I bought, and I still have it, and I still use it. Just a regular Leatherman tool. How can you, not beat the usefulness of that guy? Everything you need on it. I still carry this when I go fishing. Throw it in there. I won't carry it when I go saltwater fishing, because even though it's stainless, I just don't want to trust it around there. So there's better things I can do. Now, the little Gerber, I think it's called a Gerber Easy Out, little lock back right here. I carried this thing, this particular one, I carried the crap out of it. But I've probably had four or five of these things. Someone turned me on to one, and it's just super lightweight. Couldn't tell you what the steel is. They don't really hold an edge all that great, but man, I'll tell you what, something about this knife, it was cheap, and if I lost one, I'd just go back and get another one. It was fantastic. Absolutely loved it. I still got two of these laying around. This one has seen a lot of use, if you can't tell. I think it's been dropped a few times, dug in some dirt. So, now, when I finally decided to buy a fairly decent knife, I stayed with the Gerber. And to be honest with you, I still carry this one at work every single day. It's a Applegate Fairbane Covert. The top edge, just a false edge. I don't have it sharpened. This little lock right here keeps it from coming back on you. Partially serrated because, it's at work, and also the regular straight blade. Just a good knife. Very, very good knife. You can see how it's been worn. Great thing. Holds a good edge. 154 cm. Good steel, very good steel. Does a great job for me. And like I said, I still actually carry this, on my weak side. So keep that over there and, practice flipping it out. Now moving from the folders, very first, I would say, custom knife that I bought was secondhand. It was a Bob Dozier companion. I bought this off a guy, and I'll tell you what, the first time I held a good custom-made fixed blade, I fell in love. And, you know, from then on, it's been fixed blades like crazy. I still use this companion every once in a while, you know, just a little hollow grind right here. But I'll tell you what, this is a useful knife. Really love it. Never get rid of this thing, I don't think. Got it in some Kydex right there, too. After that, my very first custom knife that designed me and that same guy that I bought that one from went in on a design, again, Bob Dozier. I don't know if you can see that, some of his leather right there. This thing's seen some use. It's a Hunter right here that we custom designed. This joker is thick, super thick. Green micarta, red thin liners in here. This guy was completely the brainchild of somebody. This thing is heavy, heavy duty. Super sharp. Can't even begin to tell you how good of an edge it holds. D2, you know, like most of the stuff Bob Dozier makes. Great, great feel. I still carry this knife, too. Really, really heavy. I love this knife. Like I said, first one that I ever, you know, specced out and said, hey, this is what I want. You know, this is where I really realized that... You got some corrosion right there. I need to clean that up. That's where I really realized that, you know, I'm going to get what I want. You know, spend a little extra money and get what I want. And then I found Blind Horse Knives. And I started to get into bushcrafting a good bit. And this guy right here is Blind Horse's Woodsman Pro. It's got B-blasted green micarta scales on it. Red liners on the inside. Nice, big, thick handle. I'm going to tell you, this is probably one of my favorite, if not my favorite, woods knife, you know, for bushcrafting. And I've kind of progressed towards bushcrafting. I went through a little phase there where I started to get bigger knives and, you know, really enjoying that. And then I realized, you know, big knives are great, but I started progressing back towards little knives. And this one here, again, another Blind Horse Knives that I've got in a bushcrafter sheath there with, you know, the fire seal loop. Scandi Grind, little Brumby Light from BHK. Scandi, obviously. Little red liners on the black micarta here. Great knife. You know, this is the perfect size for me, I think. If I have to pick a knife, this is, you know, what I love right here. And just something about the usefulness of a little knife with me. But, you know, I'm starting to progress. I went to the big ones, and now I'm going back to the little ones. And one of the ones that I've found using myself a lot more than, you know, in the past, this is a little Frontier First, just a little patch knife. It's in D2. It's got Sandbar Stag on it, and just a great, useful little knife. I mean, it's teeny, obviously, but, I mean, what can you do? And, you know, living at the coast, I've really found that I love D2, and D2 is kind of where I've gone and kind of where I think I'm going to continue to go. The last knife that I bought, well, hold on, let me get back here. What's taken the place of my pocket knives when I'm not at work is this little flat, I think it's a small Tiger Nap right here. I just slide that Kydex right there into my pocket, and that's what I rock and roll with. Just completely flat. And, you know, this is my pocket folding knife now, essentially, because it's just so small. And this thing is super sharp. It's 01. And it's a great little thing. But the last knife that I purchased is this custom. I haven't even carried it yet. I haven't cut anything with it. Just a custom I had made. This is for work. Custom Kydex right here with Blind Horse Knives retention. Super great little guy here. Just a little custom tactical. Got some Kydex on it. You know, false edge on the top. CPM 154. The Blind Horse Knives Underground logo on it. I don't know if you can see it. This is kind of where I've gone, you know, and this is for work now. And, you know, to go from this to, you know, carrying a custom tactical, it's, you know, what do you do? So there's my knife story, guys. I hope you enjoy it, and good luck to everybody in the contest, and y'all have a great day.